Fala galera do canal, beleza?
O vídeo de hoje fala sobre paleobotânica, um assunto pouco tratado quando se divulga paleontologia.
A paleontologia é sobre compreender o mundo em mudança ao longo da história da Terra. A gente fica focando nos animais como os dinossauros e nessa parte fantástica e tudo, mas tem toda uma área para se explorar muito interessante através das plantas.
E muito importante, porque as informações que as plantas podem fornecer, elas contam a história de como o clima variou ao longo do tempo. Então, vamos falar um pouco com a professora Carol sobre paleobotânica.
Galera, não esquece de ativar as legendas, porque daqui para frente o vídeo vai ser em inglês. E no final, espero que a gente tenha uma mensagem legal para passar.
Hi. My name is Carol G, and I'm a professor of paleontology at the University of Bonn in Germany. And I'm in Brazil right now on a university field trip. So I'm a paleontologist, which means I study the history of life in fossils. And very specifically, I'm a paleobotanist, which means I study fossil plants. So I study all sorts of fossil plants, from very old fossil plants to younger ones. My specialty, though, is in the Mesozoic, the age of the dinosaurs, or as we plant people like to call it, the age of cycads. So my specialty is about 150 million years old. Those are the plants that I study. The reason why we should be interested in paleobotany is because plants are so important to all ecosystems. Nearly every single ecosystem on Earth depends on plants, because plants are the organisms that take the light energy from the sun and convert it into chemical energy that animals can use. And so if you just look around here, today's world, you see that our world is made of plants. And they're not only the basis of the ecosystem, but they also form the habitat, all the habitats that the animals live in. South America has some very special fossil floras. One of them is the Glossopteris flora in the Permian. That was a big tree that grew in forest, and it covered the southern hemisphere. I'm not only South America, but also Australia and Africa. And actually, using the Glossopteris leaves and the occurrence of these leaves, Wegener was able to formulate his theory of plate tectonics and continental drift. So you can see what an important role fossil plants have played in geological science. There are also some very beautiful and important floras in South America in the Mesozoic. As I said before, this is the age of the dinosaurs, or the age of cycads. That include members of the modern flora, the flora that we see today. That includes ferns and cycads and conifers. And finally, if you go into younger sediments, you get the angiosperms. The angiosperms are the flowering plants. They're the trees and the shrubs and the smaller plants that have flowers. And those are the plants that dominate our world today. So when I talk about fossil plants, I'm talking about plants that you find in many different forms. There's fossil wood, sometimes you find fossil leaves, sometimes you find fossil fruits and seeds. And if you look at the sediments close up, you can also find fossil pollen and spores. So all of these plant parts are used in the study of fossil plants. And we can use them to reconstruct the ecosystem. We can use these plant parts or these fossils to reconstruct individual plants, to have a better idea of what lived in the past that may not live today. And we can also use it for stratigraphy, which is the study of the age of the different layers. Because some plants, especially pollen and spores, or dinoflagellates, which are a type of algae, can be used to tell the age of certain sediments. Okay, so if you're interested in being a paleontologist, then you should study biology or geology, whichever is more interesting to you, with the understanding that you will also have to learn the other subject as well. But usually that's a lot of fun for us, because it's the merging of the two that makes it so exciting. The understanding of biology in deep time.
Se vocês se interessaram pelo assunto da paleobotânica,
não deixem de conferir a nova exposição do Museu de Geociências da USP, onde tem muitos fósseis de plantas de mais de 100 milhões de anos do período Cretáceo inicial do Nordeste do Brasil. Fica no campus da USP do Butantã, na cidade de São Paulo.
Você pode nos ajudar a produzir mais vídeos como esse, fazendo uma doação pelo nosso canal. Junte-se a outros apoiadores e ajude a realizar nosso sonho de divulgar ciência de forma livre em nosso país. Thank you.